At the Pandy Lane field, Sam and Molly were staring into the stars and were talking about their past lives. Molly went first.
And I told that to Winston Cashmore that he would never find a secretary like me. Funny to think that that was 2 years ago now.
Well, that seemed interesting. Hopefully that Cashmore got what he deserved. I heard that place was nice despite that. And I also heard a cousin of mine resides there.
Well, it was for a few years, but I later got bored, so I decided to move up to a small town in Gumbria. It was nice and peaceful, and even the postal service was better than any other I've seen. But I did feel lonely. I wanted to rekindle some old connections and find more adventure, I suppose.
I see.
Sam and Molly continued to stare at the night sky. Then, Molly decided to ask a question.
Sam, don't mind me asking, but last night when I dropped you off at your house, you called me Jeanette. I was wondering, who's that?
Sam's eyes widened. He didn't want to answer, but he felt like she deserved to know the truth. He couldn't tell Sarah and James about this, as they were still children and wouldn't understand. But he had a feeling that he could trust Molly, so he decided to tell Molly her answer.
Well, Molly, Jeanette was a romantic friend of mine at some point in life. She was someone who meant the world for me, but ended in sorrow.
Oh, what happened? Did it not work out between you two?
Well, it was more horrible than that. Do you mind listening to a long story?
No, not at all.
Well then, it was a long time ago. We met at college when we were around 17. We did an art course and had so much in common. We both had intensive interests and liked to think of new ideas. When college was over, we still kept in contact and even bought a house together. We built an old shed where we would do sort of stuff in it, and we even had a baby on the way. But then one day, around 10 years ago, a terrible event occurred. Now then, if I get the jiggle sprocket to the fiddle flange, then the ratchet burglar will hit the grommet switch, and then the Samuel Patent potato masher will work.
Sam twisted a nut bolt into his contraption and switched it on. However, the device sprung to life like a growling gremlin. The nuts and bolts sprung out of it and sped around like bouncing balls in his inventing shed.
Yikes! Stop that at once! Your master compels you! Oh, darn. That was a lovely machine. Only cost me a bargain at the summer sale at Bingles.
Is this the sound of a scientific discovery?
Not yet, Jeanette. The potato masher must have been something too exquisite to be made.
What a shame. This could have saved me from some hassle while carrying a child.
Yeah, I know. Even at the age of 21, I feel like that I've wasted some time with a job career. I love inventing, but being an assistant at Art Gallery in Newtown just isn't doing us any favours. And considering Maggie's rulership, it looks very bleak. But I will promise you, I will do anything to keep you joyful with me.
Oh, Sandbach, you do the best you can, and you always know what's best. I married you for a reason.
Sam and Jeanette had a hug. Jeanette looked over the gate and saw a bunch of men chanting and cheering loudly.
Looks like one of those firemen must be having a stack do. I'm glad they help us out in need, but they really have to be Mr. Muscle Egotists. There doesn't seem to be anyone genuine in service. Wow. Am I a bad person for saying that?
Not really. I've heard worse.
Well, I'd say we should have a rest. Take care of yourself and start over when you're ready. I shall pick up some bits and bobs.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Jet. Wait, wasn't there a gas leak in their shop?
Well, I think they've sorted it out now. Well, mustn't keep time wasting. See you later, Sam. Love you.
I love you too. Jeanette Bach. What would I do without you?
So, what happened to her?
Well...
Sam was getting quite emotional. He hadn't brought this up before, and it was getting too much to him.
There was a gas leak at one of the major stores. I was just chilling in the living room until I heard the news on the radio about the fire. I quickly went out and headed to Newtown as fast as I can, but when I got there...
Sam was nearly about to cry. He then said in a quiet, hurt voice,
"The building was in pieces. I tried to cling on it for hope, and she made it out. But the firemen told the people about who didn't make it out, and Jeanette was one of them."
Oh my, Sam, I'm sorry to hear that.
So the funeral came and it passed, but after it was done, I saw some lad being in distress as his frisbee was in a tree. I decided to try and let it out. After some struggle, I set it free, and the person was ever so happy and said I should be a fireman. I listened to that and thought it was an interesting idea. I quit my old job and did some training in Cardiff. I soon passed and eventually joined the fire service.
Oh, is she the reason you became a fireman?
Yes, in a way. I became a fireman to save lives and to never let anyone go through the same terror I went through. Although I had the same feeling with anyone like that again. Until now, I think.
Oh, really? Well, I haven't really had this much fun with someone since... Well, I can't even remember when.
Well then, would you like to give it a go all between us two?
Well, sure. I didn't see harm in that. To be fair, we could have something for even longer if I didn't move away. I wish I didn't.
It's alright. It wasn't your choice to move then. We were just children, but think as adults, it could be even better.
Well, you do have a good point there, but still, are you sure? I'm happy if you're ready to move on, but I don't want to rush you into anything.
Of course.
Right, that settles it then.
Sam and Molly decided to become a couple. They didn't know what next would come, but both were happy to have each other by their sides. They eventually left the field and went home.